I'm genuinely puzzled by Dolly the sheep. I think it's a fascinating problem. I mean, I think it's a fascinating result. But I read the paper in Nature, and it didn't seem to answer the... I mean, it convinced me that the phenomenon is a genuine one, and that's exciting, but it didn't offer any explanation of why it worked, because I would not have expected it to work, and most people in the trade would not. So I think there's a very real puzzle about Dolly.
Yeah. If somebody came along and said, we want to clone Maynard Smith, what would you say?
Not on your life, I think. My feeling is that the only person whose interest should be considered in the matter of cloning human beings is the future clone. I really would not wish to be a child being brought up knowing that I was genetically identical to this old twerp. I mean, you know, it goes back to, I remember when the... it wasn't cloning, but it was artificial insemination by famous donors was a popular scheme. And I had this image of this wretched child who had been conceived by a sperm derived from Francis Crick. And I had this sort of picture of two parents looking down at the child saying, when are you going to discover something? It'd be awful. And I think it would be terrible to be brought up as a child knowing that in some way or other you were expected to be... the genetic representative, sort of to follow in the footsteps of some already existing adult. I mean, if somebody cloned me and took the clone away and was absolutely certain that the child would never know who he was or who he was meant to be like, I don't think it would matter. But then I don't suppose they'd want to do that. No, I think the child is the person that you have to mind about in these contexts, not the person who thinks how nice it would be to have lots of copies of me.